I'm starting my education with a masterclass in Cambodia's historic recipes from a chef who is leading the country's food renaissance at a restaurant, the Sugar Palm.
I'm on my way to meet Katana, who's got one of the best restaurants in town. If I'm going to get my hands dirty, I can't think of a better place to start.
Katana was exiled in New Zealand 35 years ago when the Khmer Rouge ruled Cambodia.
It's nice and busy.
She returned 7 years ago, determined to rediscover and celebrate traditional dishes.
Hello.
Katana.
Yes.
How are you, my darling? Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
What a beautiful place.
Thank you.
That looks amazing out there. So you're clearly at the forefront of the revival of the Cambodian cooking.
I'm trying to.
Have you gone back to childhood dishes in terms of...
Yes, that's what I'm trying to do. So my mum and my grandmother recipe, trying to revise the old cooking style.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Take me back to 1975. What actually happened to the food in the war?
So people trying to stay to survive, so they could get whatever they could get around them from the jungle or from anywhere they could find, and they just have to cook anything. Mm-hmm. I just couldn't imagine what sort of thing they would eat to survive. I think that's why the food sort of gradually disappear.
So Katana is reviving traditional, authentic Cambodian recipes.
All girls in the kitchen?
One guy somewhere here behind you.
You lucky man.
The locals love it. It's a busy lunchtime service, and I'm going to learn on the job.
Now, we got order.
So first dishes.
From the clients, it's a fish amoc.
The first order in is a classic.
1 tablespoon of dry red pepper.
It starts with kreung, a spicy paste that was used before the war.
That smells so fragrant. Mm. Huh? Really
very
good.
Very nice smell. Coconut cream.
So it's not exactly healthy, is it?
No. As long as you don't eat too much, you'll be fine.
Holding.
This traditional recipe is far more refined than I expected.
And what kind of fish do you use for a mock?
I'm using freshwater fish. It's called snake head.
And this is a tradition. This is what you watched your mother making?
Yes.
Yeah, it's incredible. It's quite complex, isn't it?
Yes.
The mixture is cooked in a palm leaf.
And you're going to steam these?
I'm going to steam these.
Okay, into the steamer. Excuse me, darling. Wow, look at yours.
And the results are fantastic.
I'm amazed the way it's souffled up. That's delicious.
Delicious?
It's got a really nice, soft...
Nice texture.
Sweet
nice
texture. It's like a red pepper fish souffle, mm-hmm. but you've got the texture of the fish and the sweetness. Without being